Hello and welcome to the ASX webinar series. My name is Oran Darcy and I'm National Business Development Manager for ASX Investment Products. Today, it's my pleasure to be joined by Dante de Gori. Dante is the CEO of the Financial Planning Association of Australia, or the FPA for short. Dante, thank you for joining me. How are you?
Great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Our pleasure. Dante, most people working in the financial services industry will be familiar with you and, of course, the FPA. But for viewers that are not, could you please tell us a little bit about the FPA and describe what you do in your role there?
Sure, thank you. Yeah, so the Financial Planning Association of Australia represents around about just under about 14,000 financial planner members that operate in the country. We are national, and we do represent, I think an important point is represent individual practitioners. So our membership is made up of actual individuals who are registered and to practice personal financial advice and are listed on the financial advisor register. Though of course we have others who are looking to become financial planners and are working their way through that process as well. Our role is to represent the profession of financial planning. So we very much advocate for reform and for ensuring that there is an opportunity for financial planning to become a true profession. And some of those, as an example of the things that we have advocated for in reform, you know, the protection of the titles of financial advisor, financial planner in legislation, the education standards to ensure that there is, in terms of a profession, there is an education standard that is at a right level and it's a degree level that's been introduced at the moment. There's the financial planners are subject to a code of ethics and that there's ongoing continuing professional development across all financial planners. So that really ensures that there is, if you like, a standard and they are the hallmarks of a true profession, and that's something the FPA continues to advocate for. And I suppose finally as well is ensuring the future sustainability of the profession as well. So, you know, even though we advocate for reform, we want to ensure that that our members and those that enter the profession are able to operate sustainable and viable businesses, and that Australians can actually access and afford financial advice, which is something that I'm sure we'll get into in a bit more detail, and it's something we need to work on and as part of the role that I play here at the FPA.